Garner's one of those lucky people. He knew from early on exactly what he wanted to do for the rest of his life. Then he went and did it. By age 6, he'd already created his first animated show. By 9, Garner found out about the Haunted Mansion. This led to a trip to Disneyland. On the ride home, he told his parents that he wanted to build the things he saw at the park, and he wanted to do it for the rest of his life. So that was that. No more veterinary school for Garner. He was squarely focused on animatronics. His backyard home became an amateur Disneyland, including a haunted house for Halloween. Next Halloween was bigger and better, inside San Bernardino's Central City Mall. In a copy of National Geographic, Garner read about a robotic Abraham Lincoln, the first of Disney's highly complex audio-animatronic figures. Garner was sure he could build a human figure, too. In 1976, an animated Uncle Sam made an appropriate subject and premiered at a local mall in time for the bicentennial. It was a pretty good first try for a snotty 15-year-old kid. Garner sent a tape of Uncle Sam's performance to Wed Enterprises, today's Disney Imagineering, where it caught the attention of one of the pioneers of animatronics, Wathel Rogers. He was so impressed that he went out to meet Garner at his garage workshop. The young designer opted to test out of high school a year early and founded Garner Holt Productions in July of 1977. He was just 16. For the next decade, Garner was the sole full-time employee of his company, creating things for trade shows, more haunted houses for malls, and even a line of novelty severed hands. He needed a way to break into the majors and came up with Wendell, the world's first unicycle riding animatronic figure. Wendell opened a door to GHP's building all the animatronics for a major attraction at a new theme park in Las Vegas, all thanks to a fast pitch to the new MGM Grand Hotel's chairman, Fred Benninger. Garner hired most of his friends and half his family to help out. In 6 months, GHP built more than 40 animatronic humans, animals, props, and special effects. Work began to pour in from all over the place. More things for Vegas, projects at small parks, malls, museums, restaurants, when finally Garner's little business got a big break with an order for hundreds of a new Chuck E. Cheese animatronic figure, almost 500 in all. At last, the company Garner founded in his parents' garage was on solid ground as a business. In 2001, GHP created an animated Jack Skellington for Disneyland's Haunted Mansion holiday overlay. The figure proved Garner could build animatronics that matched Disney quality and innovation. Now, the company Garner founded, based largely on his love for Disney's animatronics, is the largest vendor for its figures, about 500 individual figures in all in every Disney resort worldwide. More than 40 years after its founding, GHP is the largest organization of its type in the world. A workshop of over 120,000 square feet, where over the past four decades, almost 5,000 animatronics in 35 countries on six continents were created. He's been recognized twice as Entrepreneur of the Year, has a Lifetime Achievement Award from the Theme Entertainment Association, and the Disneyana Fan Club's Distinguished Disney Legend Award. Garner's passion is as strong as ever. His life story is the company's. They are inseparably linked.